So the other day I was doing what you probably are doing before you clicked on this train wreck of a video. I was scrolling through YouTube looking for something new to watch, and I came across this video talking about the Loud House fanfiction community, and I was fucking horrified. Now the uninitiated are probably thinking, it's just some goofy children's cartoon, how bad can it be? Okay, maybe I'm getting a bit ahead of myself. It can't be that bad, right? Out of morbid curiosity, I decided to look up one of these infamous Loud House fanfictions, and... This decision opened up a Pandora's box of complete and utter bullshit. I started reading the shit to make fun of it, but I'm ashamed to admit that I actually got invested in this shit, dog. Wait, hear me out. This shit is an anomaly. I'm not invested in it because I approve of the weird shit that it's doing. I just kept getting roped along and wanting to see what crazy shit is gonna happen next. I can't really give you an accurate description of what the fuck is even going on, so I'm just gonna jump right in. Alright, so Jesus Christ, literally the first page. Seconds in, and we already have incest. That pretty much sets the tone of what this entire train wreck is gonna be like. I asked you if you liked it. Did you? Okay, this shit is already making me feel uncomfortable. So after they do the deed, Lincoln is fucking traumatized, man. Like, what the fuck, dog? What did he do to deserve this? He practically got assaulted by his own sister. Luna is trying to apologize and cheer him up, like that would do anything, but Lincoln basically tells her to fuck off. Then Luna gets mad and fucking punches him in the face. So there's this weird subplot where for some reason Luna is super jealous of her sister Lenny. Then we get a shower scene. You know what, I'm not gonna fucking read any of that shit. Everything was perfect. We were so happy together. But then something changed. You changed. The more I fell in love with you, the more you drove me away.
What the fuck?
Fell in love? That is your brother. What in the Kentucky fried fuck do you mean love? Next, she fucking poisons him and manipulates him into eating the food that she poisoned? I don't care if it's wrong. What the fuck am I reading? I didn't do anything wrong. I'm doing the right thing. This isn't my fault. It's someone else's fault. But it's okay. I'll make things how they used to be. I am sitting in front of my computer at 12 a.m. reading a comic about a girl being a yandere for her 10-year-old younger brother. I am at a fucking loss for words right now. Luna overhears Lincoln asking Lenny to stay home with him instead because obviously Luna's a fucking psychopath and she took this personally.
Really? Oh, so that's how you gonna play it? You gonna do this? Okay, fine. That's all I needed. That's all I needed for him to do that, and it became personal with me.
To cut a long and dramatic dialogue short, Luna is arguing to Lori that she should stay home with Lincoln instead. Lori basically tells Luna to just fuck off because she's obviously not in the right state of mind. And what the fuck is this panel?
What the hell?
And I don't know why the fuck they gave her red eyes all of a sudden just to say, hey, she's crazy now. Like, yeah, we know. So everyone is asleep and Lincoln is terrified. It looks like he's sneaking off in the middle of the night to go use the bathroom or something.
Woo! What's up with it, motherfucker? What's up, baby? Did you miss me?
Where are their parents? How is all this going on in a house full of 11 plus people, but nobody knows what's happening? Lincoln picks up his action figure and threw it at her, but unfortunately that only made her go into the second phase of her boss battle. You will not escape from this. I'll not leave you. What? So Luna proceeds to assault Lincoln again in a very creepy way, just taunting him and saying weird shit about them being in a romance together. Just, ew, dog. It's just gross. But then Luann walks in and catches her in the act. But of course, they left it on a cliffhanger. Let's see what happens in the next chapter.
It's nothing!
Nothing? Nothing? Okay, I'm so confused. Was Luna imagining all of that? How did we... You know what? Let's just fucking finish this shit so we can all go repent. So Luna goes to school and there's this group of girls that bully her. And they're basically taunting her, saying that her boyfriend doesn't really like her and he's only dating her to get closer to Lenny. Wait, she has a fucking boyfriend? I am so confused. Luna takes her boyfriend to an empty room to ask him if all the rumors were true. He does the twist villain thing where he's like, haha, fool, I don't really love you. I'm a bad guy and I just wanted to fuck your sister. So Luna gets angry and punches him, but she slaps her onto the ground and continues to insult her. By the way, why the hell did the animation randomly change? Before it looked almost exactly like the show's art style, now it's just completely different. So the generic bully girls trick Luann into pranking Luna, and then it just makes Luna even more angry. Are they trying to pull a Last of Us Part 2 where they introduce us to a horrible character, but then afterwards you're trying to make us sympathetic? Later that day in the night, when everybody else is sleeping, Luna walks past Lincoln's room, and they have a conversation that implies that Luna caught Lincoln doing some stuff.
Yo, Pierre, you wanna come out here?
In my room, I be my cup. Nutted in my sock. Keeping that door locked. Bitch, you better not.
And for some reason, she has this weird voices in her head that draws her to the conclusion that Lincoln wants to fuck Lenny. And we get...
You don't want to be like this. This is disgusting. This is awful in every way. If I could kill it, I would. But I legally can't.
You know what? I can't take this shit anymore. I'm probably on a federal watch list right now. Let's just skip over to the end to see what happens.
A few moments later.
She fucking kills Luann? Nope. Fuck this. I'm done. I quit. Just run the outro. I'm done. See you next time. Whatever.
He a fan. He a fan. He a freaky ass nigga. He a 69 God. Freaky ass nigga. He a 69 God. Hey. Run for your life. Hey. Run for your life. Freaky ass nigga. He a 69 God. Freaky ass nigga. He a 69 God. Hey. Run for your life. Hey. Run for
your
life.
Let me hear you say O-V-ho.
O-V-ho.
Say O-V-ho.
O-V-ho.
Then step this way. Step that way. Then step this way. Step that way.